Hello children, welcome back. In this module, we are going to learn adjoint of a matrix. In the previous module, you have learned about minor and cofactor of a matrix. Now, you are going to learn adjoint of a matrix. In this module, topics are covered definition of adjoint, adjoint of a 2x2 matrix and 3x3 matrix, and one more theorem which we'll see later on. So first of all, what is the definition of adjoint of a matrix? Let A be a matrix, square matrix of order n, a11, a12, a13 up till a33. Then we define adjoint of A as transpose of capital Aij. You know very well capital Aij is cofactor of corresponding elements, and the transpose of matrix of cofactors is called adjoint of A. In symbolic form, we can see if this is the matrix A, then adjoint of A is A11, A12, A13, capital A, 21, A22, A23, and so on up till A33. Transpose of this cofactor matrix will give you adjoint. This is your final matrix, adjoint matrix, in which rows of this matrix have become columns. Second row has become second column, and third row has become third column. So this matrix is your final adjoint of matrix A. Let us see it with an example. So here, first of all, we are going to learn adjoint of a 2x2 matrix. Find adjoint A for this matrix. You can see this is a 2x2 matrix. You have learned how to find cofactors in the previous module. So you can easily find out this is your A11 element. For this element, you will hide this row and this column. This element would be your cofactor. So likewise, you can calculate capital A11, 4, capital A12, minus 1, A21, minus 3, A22, 2. So adjoint of A. Adjoint of A kya hoga hamara? A11, A12. See children, here already I have written transpose of Aij matrix. A11, A12 is here. A21, A22. So you write the corresponding entries here. This is your adjoint of A. Now carefully look. Can you judge a pattern? This is matrix A. This is your adjoint of A. Is there any pattern? Yes. You are absolutely right. These are your diagonal entries in matrix A, and these are your diagonal entries in adjoint of A, and these are reversed, 2, 4, 4, 2, and these are non-diagonal entries here. Similarly, these are non-diagonal entries here, but with a change in the sign. In matrix A, these are 1, 3, and here this is minus 1 and minus 3. Yes, this pattern is very, very important for 2x2 matrix to calculate adjoint. In general, we can write, if A is a 2x2 matrix, A, B, C, D are its entries, then you can find adjoint of A by simply interchanging diagonal elements. These are your diagonal elements. Interchange diagonal elements, D, A, and change sign of non-diagonal entries. These are non-diagonal entries. Change sign of non-diagonal entries. So this is your adjoint of a 2x2 matrix. What we have done? Interchanged diagonal entries and changed sign of non-diagonal entries. Now we are going to learn adjoint of a 3x3 matrix. Let us consider this is a matrix, 3x3 matrix. as I have already told you, what is the definition of adjoint of A? Adjoint of A is Aij matrix ka transpose A11, A12, A13 and so on. Children, you have learned how to calculate cofactors in the previous module with that method. This is your A11 element. You can find cofactor of this element too by hiding this row and this column and multiplying this resulting determinant, which you will get. And likewise, you can calculate all the cofactors. Cofactor of this 3 would be A12, cofactor of 5, A13, and so on. And you will get the transpose and you will get adjoint of matrix A. This is the method which you have learned earlier in the last module, how to calculate cofactor. Just put the values of cofactor here, get the transpose, and you will get adjoint of A. But here, I am going to explain you one another method, which is very much easier. See what we'll do there. This is your 3x3 matrix. We'll make it 5x5 matrix. See how. See, this is your matrix. 2, 3, minus 5, 2, 3, 5, 6, 0, 4, 1, 5, 7. I have told you we'll make it 5x5 matrix. How? This is my column 1, column 2. Once again, write column 1, column 2. Now, you can see here 5 elements are there in the row 1, 5 elements in row 2, and 5 elements in row 3. Now, again, write row 1. 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, and row 2, 6, 0, 4, 6, 0. So, what you have got, it is a resultant array of 5x5. 5x5 matrix is here. So, first we will arrange element of matrices in this way. Now, hide first row and first column of this resulting array. Then you will be remaining with this 4x4 arrangement. Now here, make such kind of the grid. 0 into 7, 4 into 5, 5 into 5, 7 into 3. This way, put the arrows. 3 into 4, 5 into 0, 4 into 1, 6 into 7, 7 into 2, 1 into 5, 5 into 6, 2 into 4, and so on. Means what you are going to get here. See, when you will solve this, when you will multiply this, these are diagonal entries, non-diagonal. In this 2x2 matrix here, you will get A11, capital A11. By solving this, you will get capital A12, capital A13, capital A21, A22, A23, and so on. आगे देखो, नेक्स्ट मैंने आपके लिए अरे बनाया है इसका. सी, सॉरी, 0 इंटू 7, 4 इंटू 5, दिस अगेन 5 इंटू 7, आई हैव रिटन अगेन 5 इंटू 7, 3 और 5, नेक्स्ट 3, 5, 0, 4 एंड सो ऑन. मैंने ऑल अरेज डिफरेंट वे में लिख दिए हैं. नाउ सॉल्व, दिस इज योर A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. These are your cofactors. Solve. 0 minus 20. Here it is. 4 minus 42. Next is 6 into 5 minus 0. In the second row, you can see 25 minus 21. 14 minus 5, 3 minus 10, and so on. When you will transpose this matrix, you will get the resulting matrix. Make first row as first column, second row as second column, and third row as third column. This is your resulting matrix. So you can see what we have done. We have done previously, we have a matrix, we have arranged it in the 5x5 array. Hide first row, first column, then this way we'll multiply. And as a result, we'll get A11, A12, A13 and so on, getting the transpose, we'll get the adjoint of the matrix. Believe me children, you will enjoy this method and you will spare very much less time with the method you have learned, traditional method, in your last exercise. If you have forgot that method, you can go to example 22, page 125 of NCERT to see how to calculate cofactors with the traditional method. A11, cofactor A11 is equal to minus 1 raised to the power 1 plus 1 minor M11. This was the method. You can follow any method to find adjoint of the matrix, either this method or the method which is explained in example 22, page 125 of NCERT. Now for the practice, once again, I am taking a matrix A, 3x3 matrix. Here I am going to verify if I am multiplying matrix A with adjoint of A or adjoint of A with the matrix A, then result would be determinant of A into I. So we need to find out determinant of A and adjoint of A. So determinant of A, now you know very well how to calculate. Expand along any row or any column, you will get determinant of particular matrix. So I'm expanding here along row 1 and I'm getting determinant A as 11. Now you know very well what is adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is capital A is a transpose matrix, and here must written is equal to, which is missing here, and this is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23 and so on. So this matrix is your final matrix. Children, keep it in mind, here is equal to must be there, which has been missed from here. Now again, this is your matrix. Make it 5x5 array. Hide first row, first column. Draw these arrows and find adjoint of A. You will get adjoint of A, capital A11, A12, A13 and so on. These are the values you are going to get. Find the transpose of this. Make this row as a column. Second row, second column. Third row, third column. And this is your adjoint of A. So what we have calculated, determinant of A and adjoint of A. We need to prove A into adjoint of A. So write matrix and adjoint of A. Multiply these two matrices. Now in previous module you also have learned product of corresponding elements to its corresponding cofactors gives you determinant of the matrix, or else zero. See here, that is A11, A12, A13 element. This matrix is adjoint matrix. Here it is capital A11, capital A12, capital A13. Once again children, A11, small A11, capital A11, small A12, capital A12, small A13, capital A13. So you are going to multiply first one, first column, you are going to multiply elements with their corresponding cofactors. What you will get? Determinant. Determinant here, you can see, we are going to get 11. And what was the 11? 11 was the determinant of this matrix. So likewise, here in the second, this element is capital A12. This element is the product element ka first A12 element. First row, second column. Here we are multiplying A11 with what is this element? A12. This element is A12. This is A22. A13. This element is A32. So we are not going to multiply corresponding element to the corresponding cofactor. So this is else condition and we will get 0. So you can see 0, 0, 0. Only diagonal entries per will get determinant, that is the same value 11 which we have got earlier. Else we are going to get 0. So determinant of any matrix is a numeric value. 11, you can take out 11 common from here. So what you will get here? 11 common, 1, 1, 1. हम किसी भी matrix से कोई भी element, कोई भी constant common निकाल सकते हैं. We have learned it in the matrices. So what result we are going to get here? 11 into identity matrix. This is capital I. So what we have proved? A into adjoint of A is determinant of A into I. Similarly, you can show adjoint of A into A is equal to determinant of A into I. So hence, A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A, and resultant, what you will get, determinant of A into I. This is what our theorem 1 of adjoint of a matrix. If A, B, N is square matrix of order N, then A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A is equal to determinant of A into I for any identity matrix of order N. You have already seen, we have proved this result in the previous example. So for the general form, you can take any matrix A, write adjoint of A. Children, see here, A11, A12, A13, it is already transposed of cofactor matrix. Now multiply A into adjoint of A, you will get determinant of A as a diagonal matrix, and non-diagonal is 0, you can take common out in determinant of A, you get determinant of A into I as in the previous example. So A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A. This is in turn is equal to determinant of A into I. It is an important result. This is also your theorem 1. We have used reason the sum of product of elements of row with corresponding cofactor is equal to determinant of A. As a result, we have got here determinant of A else or otherwise 0. So else 0. So now children, up till here you have learned what is adjoint of a matrix, how to calculate adjoint of 2 by 2 matrix or 3 by 3 matrix, and one theorem we have done which is before you on the screen. Now you are able to solve exercise 4.5 till 11th sum. To solve, this is your homework, 1 to 11th sum. In the next module, we'll do two, three more remaining theorems, and we'll find inverse of the matrix. Till then, happy learning, enjoy fun.